My name is Jacob Colgrove. I'm Assistant Product Manager here at Redline Controls. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to connect a RAM 9000 cellular RTU to the Amazon Web Services IoT platform using our RAMQTT client driver. First, I'll show you how to configure the Amazon IoT platform to accept incoming connections. Then I'll show you how to configure the RAM 9000 so that it can securely connect with an encrypted connection to Amazon Web Services. So let's start off by configuring a thing in Amazon Web Services.
Log into your Amazon Web Services account and go to your console. And there you can go to Amazon Web Services IoT or AWS IoT. And once you get there, you'll see that there's a tree view of all the different options. Go to Registry on the left-hand side of the screen. Go to Things, then Register a Thing. The thing name must be the serial number of the device exactly how it shows on the RAM web server. So what you can do is log into your RAM 9000 and then copy the serial number from the web server on the RAM 9000. Paste that into the name field, then click on the Create Thing button. Next, we have to create a security certificate so that the RAM will be able to connect into the Amazon Web Services cloud in a secure way. These certificates are X.509 certs that provide keys for secure encrypted web communication. These security certificates and keys are more secure than username and passwords because they stay on the device and nobody else has to use them. You can assign a unique certificate per thing or use the same certificate for multiple things. To create your certificate, go to Security, then Create Certificate, and this will create the certificate and two keys. So download and archive those certificates and the keys into a location that you can find later on. Also, what you want to do is download the root certificate from Symantec, which there's a link on that page. Download that into the same location as you did the other certificate and two keys. So in this case, I'm going to rename the root certificate to rootca.pem. Once you've done that, click Activate to activate the certificate. This must be done before the RAM 9000 can connect to the Amazon Web Services cloud. Next, we need to create and attach a policy to the certificate associated with our thing that we just created. The policy can be assigned to multiple devices or things and defines the level of access that the device or thing has to the Amazon Web Services IoT platform. Go back to your Amazon Web Services IoT console, then go to Security, then go to Policies. If you don't have any other policies, you can click the Create a Policy button that appears in the main window. But if you already have policies assigned, then there will be a blue create button that will appear in the top right hand corner to create a new policy. Type in the policy name, and this should be a descriptive for the type of policy that you're providing for the device. Then for action, we'll type in IoT, lowercase IoT, colon, star, or asterisk. This will give all access to the RAM 9000 to publish or subscribe to the IoT platform. The resource ARN is the topic that the device will be publishing or subscribing to. So look at the Amazon Web Services help for the definition of what each topic does. But in this case, we're going to use an asterisk as the topic after the colon in the resource ARN, because that connects to all the topics for this policy. The first part before the colon is the resource. Check the allow box, then click on the create button to create your policy. Once you've created the policy, you need to attach the policy to your certificate. So go back to the Amazon Web Services IoT console, click on security, then go to certificates and select your certificate. Go to policies, then go to actions on the right hand corner, then click attach policy, and then select the policy that you created and click attach.
Now I'll show you how to configure the RAM 9000 so that it can securely connect to Amazon Web Services.
we'll go to the RAM 9000 web server, go to services, then go to RAMQTT client. To enable the RAMQTT client driver, select yes in the enable RAMQTT client. For the IoT cloud option, select Amazon AWS IoT. For the broker, we'll find that in the AWS thing settings. So go back to your AWS thing, then click on interact. Then under the HTTPS, copy the REST API endpoint that's listed there. Paste that into your broker field. For the port, type in 8883. This is the MQTT secure port, so it can create a secure encrypted connection to the AWS IoT server. For the minimum publish interval, we'll set that to 5 seconds. The RAMQTT client driver will only send data to the AWS cloud when the values are changing. This setting will help when values are changing quickly and you don't need the granularity of every single change. So this interval time will limit the amount of messages that are sent out when the values are changing. For the sake of this test, I'll be selecting 5 seconds, but the number would normally be set to a much higher interval to save on data usage, but it depends on the requirement of the application. The device info message setting is a pre-packaged set of RAM specific information that'll get sent to the AWS IoT server. It'll send things like serial number, firmware version number, model number. This way you have all that information available right on the Amazon Web Services. Select none if no RAM specific information will be sent. Select basic to send just a limited set of information like unit name, serial number, cell IP, uptime, version, and model. Select the full to select all the basic information plus power input voltage, full cellular information, and full GPS information. But for this test, we'll select the basic. In the device info publish interval, this time is how often the device information will get resent to the Amazon Web Services IoT cloud. Now we'll leave it at the default 480 minutes because it isn't necessary to send that information very often. The keep alive is the minimum amount of time that the connection will be left idle. If no data has changed for a long period of time, then this keep alive will send a ping if no information is needed, or it'll send an update. The track errors option sets whether an error message will be sent to the AWS IoT cloud. Click the default no in this case. For the device cert, find the cert that we had downloaded earlier. So I'll go and click on the cert that I had downloaded, find that, and then it will apply into the device. It'll take a few moments to do that. Then for the device cert, I'm going to find the private key that I downloaded earlier from the Amazon Web Services IoT platform. That will apply, it'll take a few moments. Then for the device root CA, I'm going to find my root CA.pem that I saved earlier when I downloaded all these certificates. That will apply. Now I'm going to add the IO register data that I want to send to the cloud. In this case, I'll click on the add multiple IO points button. And first I'll select the DI1 register because I have a switch connected to that I can turn on and off to test the connection. Then I'll use the filter setting here to find the seconds part of the internal clock. This will allow me to be able to see the minimum published interval of 5 seconds because the clock will be updating every second. We'll test our settings with the test server availability button. Once you get a message indicating that you've had successful communication, click the apply button. Once the changes are committed, you can go to show status to see the connection status. To get the latest information, click the refresh button. Then you'll get to see the connection status, the amount of data sent, and the last message sent, which will show up in the Amazon IoT server. To see the data coming into your Amazon Web Services IoT platform, go to your thing in your Amazon Web Services console, go to shadow, and then look in the shadow state window. There you'll see not only the RAM specific data, but also the IO register data. You'll notice that the time underscore seconds variable is updating every 5 seconds. This verifies our published interval time. Then the DI1 register will update based on the state of my switch connected to my RAM 9000.
So as you can see, connecting a RAM 9000 to Amazon Web Services IoT platform is easy. Thank you for joining me in this video, and for more tutorials and information, please go to www.redlion.net.